Well, a lot of central New York school districts are starting classes in unique ways this week, 1 week from today. The Syracuse City School District will begin remote learning until at least October 2nd. We're joined by Bill Scott right now, president of the Syracuse Teachers Union. Good evening, Bill. Happy Labor Day. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right. Let's just start out with a basic question. What's the focus this week for teachers in the district?
This week, the focus is going to be on training. What we're planning on doing and implementing is making sure that everybody is getting trained for remote learning, for distance learning, for hybrid learning. So we'll be looking at a lot of best practices and getting trained for the various platforms that we're going to be using in the buildings.
A lot of preparation. What are the major concerns right now, and what's the overall comfort level of teachers as they prepare to head back to school?
I think that staff are coming to terms with being back in the buildings, and they know that we have done all that we can as a union to make sure that their return is going to be safe for staff and students. Really, the emphasis this week is mastering that distance learning modality. It's something that teachers are not very well versed in. It's something that we picked up as we went out the door in March. Not everybody was ready to do that, but we got as ready as quickly as we could, and we've put a lot of time and energy into what we saw didn't work so that we can address that and do much better with it as we go forward.
We remember earlier this summer, the STA was urging no return to the classroom until November. Everyone okay with the Syracuse City School District plan as it stands now with the adjustments?
Yeah, as it stands, I believe that the school board and the superintendent answered a lot of questions that we had from the members that were submitted. Having those questions answered really reassured people. So as we move forward and we go back into the buildings, people know that the buildings are safe and clean. They know that, for example, they'll be working remotely on Wednesdays so that those buildings can be sanitized and that they're safe to return to. So I think a lot of the questions that were just unknowns about how are we going to do this and how are we going to keep people safe have been answered. So staff are in a much more comfortable position as we return this week.
That's good to hear. Let's talk a little bit more about that relationship between the administration and the STA. Do you think there's a good partnership now?
I do. We've had a good partnership with the district for quite some time. Sometimes matters that are more urgent to our members need to be brought to their attention, but they have been willing to listen. It's been collaborative. We also reach out to the school board and share concerns with them so that they make sure that we're all moving together towards a common goal. And when there's differences, we've been able to come together and discuss those.
I also want to talk to you about any concerns that you might have for health and safety. Are you comfortable with the plan that's set up now for screening and cleaning the classrooms?
We are. The district has been very thorough and thoughtful about their plan. The job duties and assignments and who exactly is going to be doing those screenings and the cleanings, that's still stuff that is going to be talked about this week. The district has put out hiring notices for people who are temperature checkers, people who are going to be in the isolation rooms working with staff or students who may be positive as they come through the door. If they come in and they test positive for a fever, they'll be sent to the isolation room. So the nuances of who's doing what and orchestrating that so that it runs smoothly is what we really need to work on going forward.
All right. And we gave our superintendents this opportunity, so we'd like you to also have the chance to give a message to parents before the return of school. How can mom and dad and even other adults help students get ready for school?
Well, it's certainly a new and changing environment and very challenging for us all. So I would ask that parents just remember that they're partners in this and they're part of that team. And as we go forward and we work through the bumps that we encounter together, be patient and understand that your teacher assigned to your student, your child, is doing the best that they can. And if we work together, we're going to do very well with this.
Great message. Bill Scott, president of the Syracuse Teachers Association, we appreciate your time. Thank you, and have a good rest of your holiday.
You too. Thank you.
To find your district's reopening plan, just head over to localesquire.com, click on our interactive map, or you can access all that information and more on our News Channel 9 app.